Life is just not fair sometimes. Everyone knows that. I mean, it's common knowledge, really. Life just loves kicking you when you're down, at the worst of times. I mean, I learned that from growing up just like everyone else did. You just never have enough time for anything in life. I mean, life's just a constant time crunch, 24/7. You're always on the clock. I mean, you have to balance things that you have to get done, things that you want to get done, and things that you should get done. And then, out of the blue, you suddenly have a bunch of spare time. And instead of doing the things that you should get done, and that you want to get done, and that you have to do, instead you just spend your time sitting on the couch eating Flamin' Hot Cheetos watching Saturday morning cartoons. I mean, that's just me, but I'm sure you guys can understand what I mean. And trust me, you pay the price for eating all those Cheetos. I mean, eating an entire bag of Flamin' Hot Cheetos in one sitting, that's no small feat, believe me. Back when I first started, I could barely even finish one bag. I would start getting the shakes in my hands, and I would run to the bathroom and have the shits for like 45 minutes on a good day. Usually, I'd be in there for like an hour because you gotta, you know, cool down afterwards. It's fucking brutal, man. Now I can eat like a bag a day back to back. I can be in and out of that bathroom and no problem. I'm sort of like a machine. Like, every week I ate so many bags that like I modified my body so that I'm like immune to its effects, you know? Where was I going with this? I was gonna wrap all these points into a nice, you know, like a nice whole thing, but I don't really feel like I kind of lost it, you know? Like I just sort of, it's gone. Oh well, I guess I just completely forgot. Anyway, I'm gonna go back to making my way to the post office, because I'm gonna get another welfare check. I love mail day.
What's up?
It's mail day!
Oh baby, you know what that means.
Ooh. Another welfare check.
Gonna be fat.
Let's see how much the boys on Capitol Hill gave us this time. Skimped us. There's not enough in here. They skimped us.
What do you mean they skimped us? What does that mean?
They skimped us. They really skimped us.
What do you mean they skimped us? They can't skimp us. They're the government. They're supposed to give us free money.
Take a look. It's lighter than usual.
This isn't enough to get by. What are we gonna do? What the hell are we gonna do?
Maybe we could ask them for more.
I don't know, man. I mean, I think it's time we got real jobs.
No! No! We're not doing that! It won't come to that! I refuse to do that!
Hey, it was just a suggestion, okay?
No! We can't do that! I will not allow for us to go that low! No!
You got a better idea?
Shit out. You have to look optimistic, okay? Stop looking all mopey and shit. Pick your sign back up. Look like you want to get a job.
What is your goal by this? Do you honestly think people are gonna hire us looking like this? These people won't even fucking sneeze in our direction.
Good things come to those that wait.
Don't give me that bullshit, dude.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you expect a job to fall right out of the sky into your fat fucking hands?
Why do you think I said we should get a job?
No. Real jobs are completely different. Because if we get real jobs, we become slaves. All right? Slaves! Okay? Because then we'll get a paycheck, and Uncle Sam's gonna be reaching into our pockets and our wallet being like, oh, what you got in there? A couple dollars? A couple nickels? Couple dollar bills in there, baby? We get a piece of that. We're gonna get a little chunk of that. You want that to happen? Is that what you want?
The paycheck will still be pretty decent, okay?
Now I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna stand out here looking hungry for business for hours, if it takes that. If it takes hours, we will stand out here. Because eventually, we will come across, you know, a traveler or a vagabond that will be, you know, passing through and who offers some odd jobs to do around town, okay? And it'll be cash-only transactions, you understand? Okay, all that cheddar we get, that goes to us, okay? None of it goes up to the fat asses up on Capitol Hill. It goes into our pockets and it stays there. Good, honest work.
A vagabond? This isn't fucking Middle Earth, dude.
There is no way in hell that I'm getting a real job, okay? Being unemployed was the best decision I ever made in my whole life. Because I'm a free man. I can do whatever the hell I want. All right, I feel like Neo in the Matrix when he gets unplugged by Morpheus. You know, I'm free. Like, I can see the code. Like, I am one with the machine. I see everything.
Neo doesn't use the fucking code when he first gets out of the Matrix. And that was at the end of the movie,
whatever.
Not the fucking beginning.
Whatever, who cares? Okay, he sees the code. Okay, he's unplugged. I feel like Neo.
Man, let's just get the fuck out of here already. Let's just go fucking home.
Try again bright and early tomorrow morning.
Yeah, tomorrow we'll be fucking living out here, man.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Can you close the goddamn door? You're born in a barn? Christ's sake, man. Jesus.
Is this what we've become?
What do you mean?
This is how we are. We've done this to ourselves.
Chuck. Buddy. We've always been this pathetic.
It's more than that, dude. We're about to have nothing.
I don't know what the hell you're talking about, but I'm ready for some TV and some dinner. I know we usually have Chef Boyardee every night on Tuesdays, but today we ran out, so I'm gonna have to go with the Bush's Big Beans. You know what I mean?
Excuse me, my fucking.
Hey, you!
Me?
Are you down on your luck? Feel cheated on by the economy? Do you struggle with financial difficulties and chronic alcoholism? Did your wife take everything from you in the divorce? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you're probably looking for a job. And that means that I'm the man for you. My name's Haywood, and I'm looking out for the little guy in this great country that we call America. The economy is rough these days. It's not all gumdrops and fairy tales and Bill Clinton telling everyone that there's going to be a surplus. You could try applying for a job. Yeah, right. Half the time, they don't check those online applications. You'll be refreshing your email browser for eternity. It's my job to make sure all the hardworking men and women of this country have jobs, even the ones that might not be so hardworking. So come on down to Haywood's Odd Jobs for Oddballs, Clean Money for Clean People. If you want to know where to find me, use one of the two addresses, one for the morning and one for the afternoon. If I'm not at one, I'm at the other. If you want to know where to contact me, call the number below. That's all for now, but all you great American people deserve a job.
Oh my God, dude! This is it! This is what I've been talking about!
This is what you've been talking about? The man oozes con artist.
He's an honest, hard-working citizen that understands the oppression of the people.
Is that what they call him these days?
Since when the hell do you know about hard work? You worked at Papa John's when you were in fucking high school.
It's more work than you ever done in your fucking life.
How dare you?
You don't think I've been working hard? That's what you think? 2 years I've been working on beating the Guinness World Record for biggest Red Solo cup stack. 2 years! And you say I don't work hard? Okay, it was bigger like 2 weeks ago, but it fell down. I swear it was a lot taller than it is now. Okay, I'm working on it.
Chuck, buddy, this is our last chance. You have to trust me. We're gonna lose everything if we don't take a chance like this. We can't quit now. We have to do this. I believe in it. So, this is it, I guess.
I don't get it. This is the exact address on the commercial, yet there's no office building or anything.
Well, I don't know. Maybe he's got like a shack or something back there behind the bathroom.
A shack? What do you think he is, Shrek or something? Why would there be something back there?
Look, I don't know, man. It would take like 2 seconds to go out there and check.
I'm not going back there wearing this, okay? Whatever, okay? I have to piss anyway. Let's just go in there, okay?
All right.
Just fucking...
Hey!
Hi.
Hey there. I hope you didn't have too much trouble finding me. I can't specifically say in my ads that I work out of this location. A couple guys just helped me run stuff at the park. Keep it on the down low.
Oh yeah. I'm sure you conduct a lot of business in here.
I'm sorry, you do know who I am, right?
Oh, you're that guy from the commercial! Odd Jobs for Oddballs!
In the flesh. Hey, Wood, did you blow me?
What?
Hey, Wood, did you blow me? No. It's just a name. It's just a name.
Wait, so that's really your real name?
Yes, unfortunately it is.
Hate you or something? Like, what the hell's wrong with them?
Do you have a cousin named Bend Over?
No, it's actually not funny. I've spent my entire life bullied, and I've been trying to change it for years, but I've had no spare time. So, as you guys are wasting my time, please get out of my bathroom.
Whoa, man, come on. We're just pulling your leg. We're messing with you. It's a joke, alright?
Listen, we came here so we could work for you, okay?
Are you serious? You come into my bathroom, insult me, and ask me for a damn job? Sure!
This isn't really your bathroom, you know, it's not, you know.
I mean, it doesn't really, it's not on the side.
Yeah, it's not even on, it's not on the door or anything, it's like not even, you know.
How are we supposed to have a bathroom?
Okay, it's in the commercial, okay? If you didn't see the commercial, then just... You know what, look, I'm gonna cut you guys a break, okay? 2 weeks ago, would have taken a shit in your direction. But there's a mass deportation and my employees are a little scarce right now. So we're gonna see what we can do.
Yeah.
Woo! Okay, but you have to pass an interview if you wanna get through, okay?
Okay. Lay it on us, I'm ready.
Okay, well the way my interviews work is that I give you guys a couple questions, and if you give me an answer I don't like, you get a strike. 3 strikes, and you get out of my bathroom.
Yeah, okay, I guess.
Sure.
Well, okay then. I just have a couple questions for you guys. All right, first one. Are you two legal American citizens?
Yeah, definitely.
Ooh, so, you see, that's already the first strike.
What?
So, not off to a great start here. Unfortunately, it wasn't the answer I was looking for, but you still have 2 strikes, so there's still a chance.
Fine.
Alright, next question. Are you poor?
Yes!
Oh my god.
We're so poor! We're dirt,
fucking
dirt poor!
Living in a shack.
Good to hear. Glad we're making some progress here. But hey, don't be cocky. Okay, so you guys still got a couple questions left. Okay, next one. So, Do you guys have a social security number?
Yeah,
most definitely, yeah.
Sorry, that's the wrong answer.
God damn it!
Wait, just give us
a minute. Most, I have important places to be, people.
Okay, we can't fuck this up, all right? We have one more strike left, all right?
I don't know, how the hell are we supposed to know what the answer is? Dude, it's not fair.
Dude, keep your cool, okay? Okay, just calm down.
All right, we just gotta figure out a pattern to this or something.
Hey, are you two finishing up over there? Like, I got stuff to do, come on.
Right.
About time. Okay. So where were we? Okay. Are you two homeless?
No. I'm not homeless.
No.
I'm sorry, boys. It just doesn't seem like this job is for you. That's your last strike, and that means that the interview is, well. Shit. Hello?
Jose, what did I tell you about calling my work? No, I don't want to hear it, okay? No, the only reason we should be talking right now is about my money, okay?
Oh, okay, yeah, if that's some shit, Jose. Yeah, I bet it is.
I'm not just making this up right now.
No, you know what? I'm coming over right now. All right, I got it. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Well, you know, we're just on our way out, you know.
No, you came here for jobs, didn't you?
Well, I mean, we kind of changed our mind.
Yeah. Oh, no. Nope. You guys are hired. Come on. Let's go.
All right, where did you guys park? I really don't want to use my car. It's a complicated situation.
We ain't got a car, man.
You guys don't have a car?
No.
Are you living in the Stone Age? Well, come on, guys.
We're fucking poor, dude. Why can't we just use your fucking car?
I didn't want to use my gas, but...
Oh, that's real complicated, huh?
Hey, look, I am your boss now, so can you please just, you know, treat me with a little bit of respect? Now get in.
Shotgun.
Dude, I already have it. Sorry.
What are you talking about? I called it.
I have my hand on the handle right now.
Do you think that just cancels out my calling of Shotgun?
I'm literally opening the door. I'm pulling it.
Look, I know the rules of Shotgun. I know my rights. That is mine.
Oh my God, this is retarded.
Get your asses in the car.
All right, listen up. I'll be right back, okay? You guys do not leave this car. Stay put until I get back. Even if you hear any screaming or anything, stay in this car and I'll be right back. Don't you dare leave me out to dry, okay? You guys got that?
Yeah, I guess. So, look at this fucking house, man.
It's a pretty nice house. Huh?
Yeah, I mean, you think this guy has anything to do with the mafia? You know, he's all, like, dressed up and shit?
That's ridiculous, dude. There's no way.
I don't know, man. I mean, he was talking about drugs during the phone call. We're parked outside of a nice house. I mean, this could be, like, Don Corleone's house from The Godfather.
Whoa. Dude, Don Corleone's house was way more lavish than this thing, all right? Saying that is a disservice to the Corleone family.
It's not my fault I've never been in a house this nice. What do you think he's doing in there anyway?
I don't know, and I don't want to find out. I've had a bad feeling from the start, and I'm getting the fuck out of here, dude.
Whoa, what about getting paid? Shit. Listen, Chuck.
What do you want, dude?
Dude, we need this money. This is really important. We're gonna lose our house. This is our only chance.
Hey,
can you guys pop the trunk? Can you help me out?
Hello? Can you help me out, please? Oh, man, that was heavy. Oh, thank you guys for not, you know, ditching me or whatever. Let's jet. You guys coming or what? Come on. So you guys are hired, by the way, in case you didn't realize that. Well, I was expecting a little bit more excitement, but it's okay. You guys can start your orientations tomorrow morning. But technically, you won't be paid for today because you technically don't work for me yet. But you know, you guys understand. It's just business stuff, you know.
We just want to go home.
Okay. What's your address?
It's fine. We'll just we'll get out here.
Are you sure? You don't have to walk. I can...
Nope. We're fine.
Do you want to talk about what just happened?
Nope. No, not at all. Just want to go home. I want to go to sleep.
Yeah. Me too.
What the hell is this?
I don't know, I guess it's a note or something? Oh, great.
What is it?
It's from our landlord.
What does it say?
It says, I don't know where the hell you two have been all day, but as soon as you get home and see this message, I want your asses completely moved out of this apartment. No excuses.
Wow. Who would have seen that one coming, huh?
Look, man, we just got a job starting Monday. I'm sure that if we, you know, work hard enough, we can get this place back in maybe a couple days, a couple weeks, maybe?
I sure hope so, man. Well, in the meantime, let's just pack up our shit, man.
God, what a fucking dick! Can you believe that, guy? It's only been like 2 weeks. I mean, 2 weeks overdue rent. I know, it's a problem. Everybody's got to make a living, but like, come on. It's only 2 weeks, right, Chuck? Chuck? Oh, come on, Chuck, don't be like that. We gotta be optimistic. We have a whole future ahead of us. There's tons of possibilities. Don't... Shit. Look, man, we've been through some hard times, but like everything else, we're gonna get through this, and we can do this together. Like I said before, life... just isn't fair.
Hey man, shut up, I'm trying to sleep.
This guy, he's always such a jokester.
Seriously man, shut the hell up.